Well, hello again, my friends and fellow nature enthusiasts. Welcome to Tobyhanna State Park, here in the Pocono Mountains region of Pennsylvania, where I'll be spending the evening here at Site 138. It's a beautiful afternoon in early June, an absolutely gorgeous day. It's a Saturday. And for today's hike, I'm going to be taking you on the Lakeside Trail, which is a 5.1 mile loop that goes directly from the campground here, where we are, and circles around the lake. So it's about 4:30 in the afternoon, and I've been enjoying the last couple hours just sitting here, reading, listening to the birds, and feeling the wonderful breeze that's blowing through the trees, and I think it's about time that I get up and get moving. So come along with me for a hike. We'll go explore the Lakeside Trail here at Tobyhanna State Park. Entering onto the blue blazed lakeshore trail, and a portion of this trail runs through the forested area behind the campground, and then another portion of it runs along the lake. So if I time this correctly, we'll be getting to the lakeside area in about 7 o'clock, and we should have some nice evening light for that part of the hike. So because we're atop the Pocono Plateau at an elevation of about 2,000 feet, the temperatures here at Tobyhanna are noticeably cooler than other regions. Generally about 10 degrees cooler here than most other parts of eastern Pennsylvania. So they tell you that, you know, in the park brochure, to keep that in mind. Even in the summertime, you can have temperatures like tonight, where we're going to be hitting into the mid, maybe even low 40s with clear skies. So I love sleeping in weather like that, and I'm really looking forward to getting a nice fire going and enjoying those cool fresh air temperatures. Now, there really isn't much of a trail system here at the park. The trail we're taking, the Lakeside Trail, considered an easy trail, loops around the lake, but you can also take this shoot off called the Range Trail, which is yellow blazed, and that's a little bit more of like a backcountry type experience. You're going to get off the crushed wide path and on more of a footpath deeper into the woods and like swampy areas around the park. But we're going to continue on this easy afternoon hike around the lake. So one of the reasons I like to camp at Tobyhanna here is that it flies a bit under the radar in comparison to other state parks in the Poconos region. parks like Promised Land and Hickory Run are much larger, bigger campgrounds, and there's a lot more to do in those parks, but they're also a lot more crowded. So as a campground itself, I think this is by far the nicest campground. And every time I come here, I see wildlife. I've seen bears, coyote, I've seen a deer swimming across the lake once, turkeys, all kinds of stuff. Okay, now here's the other trail possibility here at Tobyhanna, the Frank Gantz Trail, which will actually take you to Goldsboro State Park, which is adjacent to Tobyhanna here. Again, that's one way in, one way out, 3.2 miles to Goldsboro. And again, that's more of a backcountry, real like hiking trail, as opposed to what's basically a walking trail that we're on now. And that's pretty much your only other trail option here at Tobyhanna, but we're not going to do that. We're going to continue on this one, which we've been walking on, the Lakeside Trail, and it's 3.3 miles to the beach. I probably will have repeated myself several times already, but I just can't tell you how nice it is out here right now. Earlier in the week, we had temperatures. On Tuesday, when I finished work at 2 o'clock, checked my phone and the weather said it was like 95 with a feels like temperature of 104. And right now it's like probably 69, 70. No humidity, beautiful blue skies. You have this dappled light filtering through the forest, the dense green foliage here. And this is what it's all about. This is easy peasy, lemon squeezy, if that's how you say it. I'm happy. It's all good. All right, guys, so you can see in this little soft muddy spot here, all these tire marks from bicycles. So again, another thing here at Tobyhanna that you can do is bike ride this 5 mile loop, because it's, I would even say kids could do it and families can do it because this trail is so level and smooth. Another interesting thing about Tobyhanna State Park here is that it's adjacent to the Tobyhanna Army Depot. And this whole entire state park and the surrounding area was at one point part of a huge military base. And it's explained on the website and in the park brochure that there have been unexploded ordnances found in the park from, I guess, bombing and military tests that were conducted, you know, many decades ago. So you're strongly advised to not wander off the marked trails. And that may be another reason why this is one of the lesser visited parks in the Pocono region, I would suspect. We've definitely made it to the other side of the lake now. I can tell because the sun is on the opposite side of me. I thought we were gonna cross like a dam or something, but there was nothing like that. So you can see to my left there is the edge of the lake, but it's more of like a marshy, swampy area. And yeah, we're just moving along. Beautiful walk tonight. Beautiful. Gorgeous conditions. This side of the lake features the day use facilities. So you're gonna have a lot of these little like fishermen paths, I call them, that take you down to the water where people fish. That's what we're on right here. That's a beautiful spot though. I wait till you see this. So this is really one of my favorite spots here in the park, the dam area. I've fished from this location many times, caught a few small bass. A lot of the larger yellow perch and, you know, bluegill. Fishing here is hit or miss, but it's certainly a nice place to sit and watch the sunset, that's for sure. We made it past the little waterfall area, across the bridge. Now we're on top of the dam. And this is probably this is like the scenic overlook, quote unquote. This is the highest elevation you're gonna get, about 15, 20 feet. And as I had said before, there's just a multitude of these spots along the trail here where you can stop and just sit by the water or throw a line in if you're a fisherman and just enjoy it all. If you're still watching right now, by the way, I want to say thank you. I want to say I sincerely appreciate you. I know if you're still watching at this point, you're a dedicated viewer, and thank you. Your support means everything to me. That's what keeps me going. So thank you.
very near 7:30 now. We've been walking for almost 2 hours and 45 minutes, and you can still see how much light there is. I mean, you're going to have, I think sun set is about 8:30, but you're going to have ambient light till 9 o'clock, you know? It's that time of year. Oh, this is so beautiful. This is lovely. And of course, here's the boat rental and one of the main areas of the park. Some guys fishing on the pier. You can get firewood here, ice, and rent boats. I can hear the campground, which is on the other side of the lake there, all the way from here. So probably some people have showed up since, you know, I went for this walk, and probably everyone who's camping is probably just about back in camp now. So it's a Saturday night. I didn't expect a quiet night, but you know, that's what you get on the weekends. All right, my friends. That's going to do it for today's hike, the Lakeside Trail at Tobyhanna State Park. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a like. If you have any comments or questions, let me know down below. I thank you. I appreciate you. The bugs are getting me real good right now. There may be a part two to this video where we take the kayak upstream. If not, you've got a good overview of the trail and the park in this video here. Thanks a lot, guys. I'll see you on the next one. Gator out.